Time. We'll talk about it more. Match about to start. Best of seven, Fan Zhendong with the serve. No time wasted. A quick backhand and a forehand down the line. You know, Ma Long's match against Wang Chun-ting for me was just one of those matches that makes you think, how can anybody beat Ma Long? But, you know, an unstoppable force meets an immovable object, and that's what this match is.
I agree. Just interesting in that first point, the way Fan Zhendong takes it to Ma Long. Not seeing Ma Long kind of at sea almost on the receiving end of big hits from the opponent.
Right, rarely does he look jarred.
I wonder, did they toss a coin for who would wear the traditional red shirt for China before the match started?
For some reason, just in memory on the World Tour, I feel like these are what they like to wear. I feel like I remember seeing Fan Zhendong in this uniform more than Ma Long, and Ma Long in the Chinese red. It's always nice when you agree on which side of the coin you want.
Exactly.
So for those of you a little bit newer to the game, Ma Long became the most dominant player on the planet in 2015. He was arguably the most dominant player before that, but clearly in 2015, winning everything it had to offer. Fan Zhendong in 2015 in the Chinese Super League went 35-1, only losing once, and it wasn't to Ma Long. He won three times out of three against Ma Long in the Chinese Super League, and this year he beat Ma Long in the Chinese Super League again. It was a very tight two-point margin in the deciding game.
That's another factor that comes into this, Adam, right? We can look at the World Tour and when they're on the international stage, but actually given that they're playing each other in their home domestic Super League, gives you a real sense that actually they know each other very well, and that can sometimes have a dynamic and an input into the outcome of matches.
Yeah, absolutely. It's interesting how the pressure changes depending on what the title is and where you're playing. Even though Fan Zhendong won three times in the Chinese Super League last year, he couldn't win a single match on the World Tour against Ma Long. So there's clearly some factor based on ambience out here, the ambiance, if you will.
And after that first big acceleration off the blocks for the first point, it's Ma Long with five in a row. Solid. Thought that was going to develop into an unbelievable rally. It was good enough as it was, Adam.
Yeah, that point's incredible. So much power both sides. I mean, the finish, it looked like it slipped off the rubber a little bit for Ma Long, so a little bit anticlimactic at the very end. But, yeah, what a point in the caliber of shots coming in. This is why you love watching these two play, because very few people in the world can return them. Oh, almost a sideways shot with the arm just lifting it up. One more time. Strong opening.
I mean, incredible there. Watch how Fan Zhendong reacts. His bat is actually coming back to the center of his body. For most players in the world, that Ma Long ball would have hit the barrier as a clear winner. But,
right.
But these guys, they're just so good at anticipating and moving so, so quickly. For Fan Zhendong even to contemplate getting something close to the table is quite remarkable.
Yeah, definitely confidence, some bold play out here.
I'm just interested to see how the tactics develop, see if there is a clear sign that either one of the two has a real clear tactic on a weakness of one of these two guys. And I don't think weakness is the right word, because when you see these guys playing, as in the top of the women's game too, it's phenomenal stuff.
Yeah, but it's fair enough. I mean, it's all relative, right? I mean, they're the two best players on the planet. I don't think there's anything that they do poorly, but relative to the rest of their game, finding out what it is that will be the least threatening coming back. A little bit too high over the table. Ma Long exploits the opportunity close to the net. Really comes around that corner again. It's not an easy shot to keep your balance. We saw it in doubles a few times with Oshima and Masataka Morizono. But Ma Long, even on that last ball, still adds some side spin to it coming around the ball.
I mean, it's a difficult shot sometimes right over the table.
Oh, yeah.
The Chinese guys and girls are so quick on the footwork to get in over the table, practicing hours of multi-ball.
Yeah, the footwork, the physical fitness. There are a handful of things that set the top Chinese players apart from the rest of the world. But it doesn't come easily, that's for sure. Super competitive to have this career that they both have. Look at that forehand flip kill, the sound, the crack of the bat.
The variation of serve has been noticeable in the last couple of sequences from Ma Long. Little short topspin that time, Fan Jiandong just popping it. I wonder in the short forehand receive, is that where Ma Long's going to Fan Jiandong?
Anything he can do to avoid that backhand, the banana flip? Now Ma Long's serves, talked about it before, they're not flashy. But if you ask any of the players, they're so difficult to read. Well placed, right into the body.
The other thing I notice about Ma Long is he's receiving a lot of serves short. Again, probably because of the big power, the big backhand that you mentioned there, Adam, from Fan Jiandong. Just right. See it there. Trying to restrict the 19-year-old. So powerful when he starts to wind up in open play. We saw that against Dmitry Ovcharov in particular.
Now, with all the physicality and all that table tennis includes, I think really the sport, and this is true of a lot of sports, but in table tennis especially, quick decision making. And you talked about the short receive. For Ma Long, it seems like if the serve is attackable enough that he can confidently hit it hard, he'll go for the attack every time. But if there's any question, he's going to try to deter Fan Jiandong because he doesn't want to give him a 7 out of 10 loop. Even though Ma Long's 7 out of 10 loop is enough for many players, against Fan Jiandong, he's going to be swallowing the next ball.
Fan Jiandong seemed to stop on that one. Not sure whether they thought it was a net or maybe he just miscalculated. 10-5, game one in this men's singles final.
There it is, Ma Long, 11 points to 5. A very impressive performance. Turn things around. Not just yet. Now, one thing about Ma Long's serve, someone asked me recently, Adam, what's he doing in there? It seems like a pendulum serve, but it's very close to the body. Is it? And the truth is, most of the time it is. I mean, that is the contact. It's just a question of the variation of spin on it. Sometimes, because he doesn't follow through, it's heavy spin. Sometimes a bit more side than under. And you'll still see him, I mean, between aces and long serves to the backhand occasionally, he does mix it up quite well.
This is looking ominous already, I have to say, for Fan Jiandong. I think Ma Long's just restricted him in game one. His service sequence there, Fan Jiandong looks as if he's never played him before on those receives.
Yeah, it did appear that way in that point.
And Ma Long's just coming in behind it, and Fan Jiandong knows it. And so you end up in those situations almost trying too hard.
Right, and not to say that YouTube comments are perfect for news, but it does give you a sense of the opinion sometimes. A lot of people feel that Fan Jiandong is there, that he's already passed by Ma Long, but I haven't seen Ma Long softening up at all. Every match in the Chinese Super League, on the World Tour, he's still playing his heart out in great form, is not suffering injuries. I mean, it could really be some time before Fan Jiandong does pass Ma Long by. Oh, man, again with those quick shots, but still it's Ma Long who keeps his composure and gets the down-the-line finisher with the forehand. And the backhand, now both players here have a strong backhand. I'd favor Fan Jiandong's backhand if it was just backhand to backhand, but Ma Long using his backhand so that he can turn the corner on the next ball. And it takes that sort of confidence to not give up your footing. This is part of the reason Xu Xin had a little bit of a falling off. Even when he was number one in the world, had a losing record against Ma Long and Zhang Jike. But he was just punished for stepping around and taking so many forehands. In the modern game, it's so necessary to have a strong backhand. I think Hugo Calderano is a great testament to that on his way up right now. And this time, even with the backhand, Ma Long just a little bit on the heels for a moment and quickly running through the opportunity, the doorway here. Fan Jiandong plays it open. Short, he makes such a short stroke with that forehand.
Beautiful technique.
But nonetheless, the score quite similar to game one. Fan Zhendong still has some catching up to do.
I mean, it's an interesting talking point, Adam, you know, when Fan Zhendong could progress further. You know, there are lots of factors in that for me. One is progression, two is capability within the Chinese team, three is results around the world and, you know, decisions made around who's best to play in the World Championship so that China put themselves in the best place to win. We're at the start of an Olympic cycle once again. Ma Long's 28. Injuries, everything, state of mind, how well they're training. I personally think Ma Long could stay on top for at least another 2 years.
Two? Wow. It's definitely possible. I mean, he's in great form.
But the question would be to Tokyo. 4 years, I think we'll see change in 4 years.
Yeah, I think about it a lot, too. I mean, I know it's one of the great talking points of the men's game for table tennis fans around the world. You know, you've got the greatest of all time question. You've got Ma Long versus Zhang Jike. And right now, Fan Zhendong versus Ma Long is the real question. These are the points. So many points. Ma Long even backing off when he has a little bit more time. Like a cannon comes back with this backhand. Fan Zhendong with the first ball there. That was the one that jammed him. Not a long time to recover. Just one shot soft. And the next ball blasted back. You know, I still don't believe the way this match has started. Fan Zhendong has played some outstanding shots. But it's just been a little bit below his level.
And the word for that I think springs to mind for me, Adam, is restriction. I think Ma Long is just restricting him. He's containing him right now. Again, whether it's because he's keeping the serves a little bit tight. I mean, Ma Long hasn't gone for anything long and loose or free yet. He's keeping him nice and tight, probably because he knows how powerful he can be in open play.
And that replay right there, the chop block just bending so much.
And another example on the receive. Most of Ma Long's receives are short. I think that's a reflection on him saying, again, I need to restrict this 19-year-old explosive compatriot of mine because, again, in open play, he's amazing. But there's another example. In short, yeah. Fast spin.
I agree with everything you're saying. I'm curious if Fan Zhendong, because often he's able to raise his level and contest. You know, he's got outstanding feeling and touch. We've seen it throughout with the Star Awards point of the year. Throughout his match with Koki Niwa.
Absolutely.
Here's some power. But yeah, in the short game, even if it means a few more touch shots before getting into the big bomba, as they say in Europe, just sort of finding the timing to set up when he can take advantage of getting Ma Long a little bit out of position. But so far that hasn't happened. The dictator in control in the driver's seat. Man, sets him up, knocks him down. The receive game, talk to me, Johnny.
Yeah, let's just have a look at this receive again, see what we think.
For me, it was a little bit in between. It wasn't, he didn't decide to go long and really push it deep, and he didn't come under it enough to try and keep it short for a second bounce on the table. It just floated.
So here's the thing, how many times has he flicked over the table, Fan Zhendong? That flick that he's synonymous for when he was playing Dmitry Ovcharov, he was all over. The youngster responds. We saw him 2-0 down against Dmitry Ovcharov in the quarterfinal. And he came back firing.
Look at these backhands. I mean, it looks like someone's just trying to set a record here or something. So many back and forth. They're looking for the middle in both. You could even see in the replay there that Ma Long trying to find the middle, trying to move it around a little bit, but the pace, I mean, he's trying to add to the pace. They're both challenging each other with every shot. So game one, Fan Zhendong got the first point. Then it quickly turned around.
Dropping.
This is incredible. Again, the caliber of play. I was surprised that Fan Zhendong took a forehand early on in the rally. But after that, every single shot, he's hitting it so hard. I mean, if you told someone, it's like when you hit the bell with the hammer to see how high up the thing goes at the carnival. it's like every shot he hits, he's hitting as hard as he can just to see if he can break the record.
And win the cuddly toy.
Yes.
Oh, he's back, he's in. He's maybe just had a word with himself at the break there to say, you know what, come on.
Wake up, this is the slap to the face that sometimes you give yourself and it's like, it's now or never, come on, let's do it.
Or maybe he's playing with us all, Adam, you know, 2-0 down against opponents and then start to really fire back.
Nobody plays with Malone. This is off the table. But he did pass the back line of the table. If it wasn't clearly off the side, this could be trouble. Beautiful flip.
That was an all or nothing.
That's right. No coming back from that. I feel like I've seen one once or twice. Maybe Ma Lin in the Russian league. Some shots like that. That's where you get to see a little bit of toying around. There's a look of dejection right now. Fang Zhendong, it's just so different mentally. If you look at the history of these two as personalities, as individuals within the greatest nation of table tennis, Fang Zhendong fighting to prove himself once again on the big stage. You said it before, he's 1-8 against Ma Long, only taking his first win earlier this year at the China Open. So he does have a lot to prove. Last year, it was the Men's World Cup where he lost 4-0, and for me, much like at the Olympics versus Zhang Jike, the question was game one. If Fang Zhendong had taken game one against Ma Long, I think it would have been a completely different match. And it was quite close, Fang Zhendong was ahead, but then the next three, Ma Long steamrolled, and then quite differently, going to 11-9 in the seventh, at the end of the year, the culminating World Tour Grand Finals in Lisbon. There's nothing more satisfying than watching one of the greatest conversation topics unfold before your eyes. Just the amount of anticipation on this match right now. Just a little bit more on the elbow from Ma Long and it jams up Fang Zhendong. Oh yeah, go ahead.
No, I was just gonna say, interesting that Ma Long goes after the Fang Zhendong backhand.
Right, it's bold, very brave. But if he does it right, you can see that he's anticipating well where the ball is gonna come back and he can quickly turn, doesn't move until the point of contact and gets a full forehand swing.
And that may well be the first long serve in this match we've seen from Ma Long. So mixing it up slightly.
To love it. I mean, backhand to backhand, turning the corner, Fang Zhendong testing out both sides. So much pace. This is even in the practice hall, you see these guys hitting. It's not like this. This is, you know, practice hall, they're practicing 100%. And as Quadri Aruna said, playing at 110. Just a little extra something there that you can't quite explain. The adrenaline when the crowd's behind you, when the title's on the line. Pulls out performances that physically you might not have known you were capable of in the practice hall. Getting some vocalization from Ma Long. We've seen the stress on the face of Fang Zhendong. Had the lead here early on. Dead even here. It's the closest game we've seen at this point in the game. I mean, he's already tied his score from his highest scoring game. Fang Zhendong only got 5 points in his highest score in game one. So the cameraman giving us a little view of the upper half of the court of Ma Long's side.
Yeah, it was another fast serve from Ma Long. Long serve didn't pay off this time. Maybe it's too frequent. First two games, he continued to serve short of the Fang Zhendong forehand.
could come down. Oh, man, it looked like he almost had a chance to get it before it went over the barriers.
Did it hit the edge
of the table?
Did it? I'm not sure. I can't see past Fan Jiandong.
I don't think so. If it did, it caught a pretty good top part of the edge because he was able to play it. I think it just came down really wide with a bit of side and backspin on it.
He didn't make any mistakes on it anyway. He made sure.
We've seen it before. It wouldn't be the first time that somebody missed this ball. You know, earlier in the year, Ding Ning and Liu Shiwen, Ding Ning had a ball off the edge of the racket like that that came down on the back edge of the table, went viral on Facebook. Official ITTF Facebook page. Check it out for some cool action. A little bit of miscontact at the top edge of the racket for Ma Long, but still it looked like that's where he intended it. 1 point lead now for Fan Jiandong, Xiaopeng, as he's affectionately called in China.
And a bit like the women's singles final that was just on before this, you know, 2-0, I actually think maybe this is the crucial game. It was similar in the previous match where, you know, Zhu Yuling managed to go 3-0, but had she not, that might have turned the table slightly. And I'm getting a similar feeling here, Adam. If it goes 3-0, you feel that Ma Long is very, very good. He'll be coming into the home straight. But Fan Jiandong, we know, has come back from 2-0. He pinches this one. It's game on.
Absolutely. I think one thing that makes Ma Long so unstoppable is the confidence that he gained. You know, even with a winning record over his biggest rival on the team, the question was, when it really counts, will he beat Zhang Jike? Will he step up? You know, the winning record isn't the most important thing. But yeah, having a 3-0 lead in the confidence of the last 2 years, Ma Long will be very difficult to stop when he's loose.
He certainly wasn't loose on that one. That's a rare miss. You wouldn't see that. Haven't seen that so often from the number one in the world.
You know, from this camera angle, we had a better look. It wasn't quite as easy to hit. We could see there that it was a little lower, still over the table, leaving the table as an obstacle. But yeah, he usually does make it.
See Fan Jiandong, he's now trying to get himself in a position to play in the backhand flick. I think that's a pivotal part of his game, you know.
It is. With Ma Long on the other side of the table, it's just dangerous because he's got the deep backhand shot to get back for, and it's going to be testing. It's going to come back quite fast. So he's a little bit more vulnerable, as quality as that opening banana is.
So let's see here. Ma Long always going short during the first two games.
Oh,
incredible stuff.
Three shots longer than it would go against anybody else. This shot from down below the table right here. Look at this, comes right back into play. Ma Long's ready, recovers one. Fan Jiandong has to play two brilliant shots after this. I guess one after that, two brilliant shots in a row to win the point. I think Ma Long is starting to feel the pressure of winning this game. You can see the look in his face. He knows he has to take this game. There's going to be no cruising, but it will be a lot easier for him if he takes this one. Still a chance. I mean, he's been within 1 point, back and forth. They're really just going for pushing ahead by the littlest, the slightest margin.
But look at the effort that Ma Long went to get that ball short to Fan Jiandong's forehand.
Right.
Ma Long's gone right across the table and hoiked it across, desperate, I'd say, to keep it away from the Fan Jiandong backhand. Because again, it's unbelievable backhand that that young man plays. Just seems to open the whole court from him. It's like the tin opener. As soon as he flicks that backhand, the tin opens and he's in.
Hooked is the same as hooked, right?
Something like that.
Okay, all right. Oh, by an inch, so close, has the opening, goes boldly with the backhand. This could be the point that is the turning point. You'd talked about it, we had talked about it out here. It's a risky shot, he's made it before, but there's so much pressure to keep it right on the line. Just a few centimeters inside the line, and Ma Long could have a reach on it and hit it back cross court. Now game point after trailing the whole game for Ma Long. 6-0 after an incredible game three over Fang Zhendong. That backhand, when have you seen one that Ma Long couldn't touch? Not even deflected, just went right past him.
That's the reason why I think he's been trying to keep that backhand out of the match so far. But that was an incredible ending to the third game there, Adam. Ma Long again, there you see, serving short to the forehand. He pops it up, and Fang Zhendong, the speed with which he brings his body in over the table, zipping through that ball.
And again, just a little bit of side spin on it. You can watch as the balls bend away toward the barrier, but two shots untouched in the first 2 points for Fang Zhendong. Forcing Ma Long into a chop. Now, remember when we were talking earlier, I was mentioning that if Fang Zhendong can play the short game a little bit more, he's choosing very wisely when to open up, and it seems to be paying off. He's got Ma Long chasing there just a little bit, out of position.
And again, Adam, it's the backhand that started the rally for Fang Zhendong there. So, you know, I think if he gets the backhand in over the table, he puts himself in a very strong position in any of the rallies.
Right, I think that in combination with having Ma Long in at the table. Almost, just the side. That ball could have been another roller.
Star awards all over again.
Wins 2017 with the last shot of 2016. So much side spin, way wide. Ooh, from below the table. Look at this.
Isn't it amazing, though, that a player with so much power has so much feeling?
Ferdinand, this is the bull that stops to smell the roses. Right? Remember that book? Oh, the back edge. Speaking of touching, I think we went from touch to touching. Just one more time. Yeah, he's opening early, challenging the forehand. He's just trying to pick different places on the table, I think. Keep Ma Long guessing a bit as to where the ball's gonna come. Again, moving it around with the backhand receive, this time opening it up cross court. I wouldn't be surprised if Fang Zhendong gets another chance at some around the net touch shot. I was just wishing that ball had slid and rolled. Both of these players have the capability. I mean, you can see viral videos of them doing around the world type trick shots and everything else. And they're off time in the practice halls and the training in China. That served just a little bit too long. Ma Long taking advantage, jams up Fang Zhendong right at the crossover point. Yeah, he had a clear first stroke at that. This one gets away. Ma Long had 2 points in a row from down 1-4. Ball sits up a little bit, but still a difficult one to reach. Ah, come on. Now for the long serves that Ma Long does, that one was just a little bit inside the baseline. His most effective serves jam up Fang Zhendong, coming right to the base of the table, right at the white of the line. This is how ready they have to be at any moment, even playing the let serve just in case the other player didn't see it. I guess the other player and the umpires, for that matter, anybody.
Again, the backhand from Fang Zhendong coming into play. Much more in the last two games than in the opening two.
And after three in a row from up 4-3, Fang Zhendong allows Ma Long to come back within two. within three anyway.
Oh, that's a great ball. Again, another example, we've spoken about it a few times through the week, where it's not always about the power, but, you know, placement and angles. This is a great forehand from Fan Jindong.
Yeah, it's interesting. If you ask someone to try and describe the perfect table tennis shot, I mean, there's so many variables, so many different factors to consider in any given moment. But on top of that, it really depends on who the opponent is, where they're standing, what their strengths are. Fan Jindong knows this and has to consider it on every shot, just like Ma Long. But that forehand flip kill, despite missing one or two, is still so deadly from Ma Long. He just has all the ingredients.
The power coming through the ball. Watch how he steps in through the ball. Look, right, plays it completely. Worth noting, you know, when you're being brought over the table, you still play 100% through the ball, even though there may be a risk that you get caught on the return, but, you know, maybe at club level, we all play a half shot in those instances because we don't want to commit our body, but in doing so, we leave ourselves open.
And this is the difference in physical fitness. The fact that Ma Long can confidently take it and know that he can get back. When you spend energy, if you're not at this level of play and you're not as fit, you sometimes just sort of allow yourself to give up a little bit. You think, I'll make up for it with a touch shot coming back. I'm so good at dropping the ball, whatever it may be. My block is solid. Ma Long doesn't depend on that. He gets in position for every shot that he can. Racket speed on that forehand, one after another, just a hurricane of hurricanes. The second ball was even a little bit into the body. Look how much he turns and gets the upper body out of the way. Fan Jindong not able to find the middle. The pressure comes right back even stronger. That one sits up a little bit higher than the last chop block that begged for the potential shot of the year. It could be. Trying to just kill it while it's high. So much side on that to bend it out, make it a little bit more difficult to reach. It's funny to start a sentence with "it goes without saying," but Fan Jindong needs this game. And he's got three opportunities here to do it. Three game points for Fan Jindong to get his first game this match. And it's still a long road, but from down 0-3, it would be the sweetest revenge there is.
Again, it was the backhand that did the damage. Flick over the table. And then another follow-up strong backhand from Fan Jindong.
There it is, as you said, Johnny, backhand. But it is a bit of hope, and we know what he's capable of between the Chinese Super League and earlier this year at the China Open.
Ma Long gives a shout of celebration and skips to the barrier for the ball. He's put the engine down a gear, revving it up again.
Well-placed serve, keeps it low and right at the back of the table. If Ma Long has trouble with it, you gave it to him. Doesn't make many mistakes. Now you couldn't see the bounce, but you could tell by the first bounce of that serve and the sound that that was deep on the table. This is how Ma Long's fast long serves go. It's interesting how much of a tell the first bounce of the serve is to predict what the second bounce will be. And he gets there for the counter. Just can't put it down on the table. The power that Ma Long has, as you mentioned before, on that full commitment forehand flip kill. And he was on his toes leaning over the table at the end of it. It's going to be a really tough ball if it comes back.
3-1, 3-1. Big sequence of two from Fan Jindong here.
Yo, short side of the table.
What a forehand. Even sat here, Adam, I didn't have any idea where he was going to put that one.
Yeah, I expected it cross court. It
just watch the footwork. Oh, the power and the weight transfer onto the left side. Incredible.
Oh, it's broken. They're going to replay it. Oh. Well, the question is, Fan Zhendong was on the lucky side of this call against Dmitry Ovcharov.
And we know the rule is that when it breaks, it's a let, right?
Regardless if it breaks,
of where
well,
it hits.
Right.
So that was a top edge from Ma Long, so you might have said, actually, it's a top edge, so you lose the point, but it's the fact that the ball is broken and it's replayed, yeah?
Right, it's letter of the law versus spirit. The spirit is if the ball could have been played in play, you know, then the point continues. If the point clearly you missed, like had the ball gone the opposite direction, sometimes we've seen calls go the other way. Was this the score before the ball broke? Good, okay,
yeah.
So they're replaying it. It's nice to see consistency. While it can be a tough call, it's
agreed.
The right call.
Exactly.
I don't know what that means.
Very philosophical. I like it, I like it.
So Fan Zhendong fighting to come back here. You know, if you really think about what that crackball point means, it's a big point for Fan Zhendong right now. So mentally, he does have to stay composed. He's within 1 point, having won the last one. I don't know about you, but that sound, as far as concentration goes, no flash photography, but the fans also have to know not to make loud sounds at the point of the high toss serve. We'll see. I mean, it is a stadium, it's a sport with a bunch of people here cheering in the arena. I think basketball games in the US, people do whatever they can to mess up a free throw. So I guess it's all part of sport. Oh, man, forehand flip, no problem. Just feeding Fan Zhendong a down-the-line forehand.
That's top, top drawer
too
from
pretty.
Fan Zhendong.
Yeah. Racket head up, just holding it out there. If you want to see the still shots of some of this magic, check it out on the official ITTF website, ittf.com. Second bounce on the table, fools Ma Long, the bite of the ball, just enough backspin to keep it inside the baseline. Look at this again.
Highest very quality from Fan Zhendong the last couple of points.
And one thing they both have in common on that serve is they don't follow through much at all. They leave as little clue, as few hints as possible as to what's on the ball specifically.
Change of serve style from Ma Long.
Ouch, off the table, just a swat of a backhand to rip. This is 5 points in a row for Fan Zhendong, and with style. The confidence to back off and let Ma Long hit a few at you before you just turn. One backhand, that's all it takes from 10, 15 feet behind the table.
Crazy, incredible stuff.
World number one, this is Ma Long. This isn't just some random professional.
The other very impressive thing, Adam, is you know, Fan Zhendong's only 19. I know he's won big tournaments. He's number two in the world.
Here for the World Tour Grand Final title. Yeah, it really does make you wonder, what will his peak be? What age? What will it look like? Can't even imagine. It'll be something new for pretty much everybody in the world.
Was the right one to go for. We've seen him convert those, Fan Zhendong, time and time and time again. Ma Long just not pressing Fan Zhendong just as much as he did do in the first two games in particular. Fan Zhendong had the opportunity to dictate the change of pace, but just didn't convert.
Dictating the dictator, huh?
That's the one, I nearly could say it.
Oh.
Whereas now here, Ma Long dictating again. It's him who's playing the spins and keeping Fan Jiandong guessing. These are dangerous times for the 19-year-old now. Back to 7-all. Momentum swings back to the man in red.
And a timeout.
Probably a good timing for that. What do you reckon?
I was going to say jinx, because we both said timeout at the same time. Wow, no, I think that's a great timeout. I think if he can get Ma Long in over the table but not allow the forehand flip kill, which is a very tall order. But Ma Long forcing it right into a quick rally. It's a big point to take the lead. Four in a row for Ma Long, and the timeout has not stopped the comeback.
I actually fancied Fan Jiandong after he flicked the serve. I thought he was in on the backhand.
Yeah, it hasn't been enough consistently. Again, so many factors. The placement, we saw the first two games, even with the backhand flicks. Oh, man, the opening, the turn on the corner.
That's the moment where he says, I'm the world number one. Number two, know your place.
Oh, man.
Fantastic.
Fan Jiandong getting out fantastically played right now. He's got two serves to try and tie it up. A few extra bounces, a little extra thought. Leaves it up a little too high, and Ma Long a chance to defend his title and take it right here. We've got championship points for the 2015 world champion, the last world singles champion that the men have seen.
That's the point for me, Adam, that kind of really sums it up. Short touch to the forehand from Ma Long. Fan Jiandong pops it. Ma Long's in.
Soft touch. He's going back to the soft touch. And talk about nerves. The ball barely comes off the back edge of the table when Ma Long gets that first swing. A little bit too long, and the opening goes to Fan Jiandong. It looked like he was trying. I couldn't tell what he was trying to do. I thought he might go long to the backhand, but it looked like an attempted half-long serve, Johnny.
I think it's too loose. I think that's exactly what he didn't want to do. That's Fan Jiandong's bread and butter.
Right. In between, lukewarm, you're hanging yourself out to dry. So two game points saved, two championship points saved. One more championship point here for the Dragon. Oh, the backhand down the line. Crushing power, Xiao Pong. Three
Fantastic
saved in a row
from Fan Jiandong.
Unbelievable 3 points. The job is not over yet, but it becomes a stressful work day for Ma Long.
But again, Adam, it was Fan Jiandong got in with his backhand flick again, and from there, I think that settles him into his rhythm. But to play that ball right there down the line, that's a bone crusher.
The bold, bone crushing backhand. Triple B from Fan Jiandong. B cubed, if you will. And it continues. We've got game points. Don't give up yet, fans. Don't pack your bags. Don't turn off the TV. Not now. My goodness. I haven't had heartache like this since the Dima match versus Fan Jiandong. Suspense is killing me.
Quite surprised at Ma Long sticking with that high serve, the high toss. I thought he'd have changed it because he was 10-8 and lost both. I thought he might have changed it. Fair play to him for sticking with it. He knows something that we don't.
Definitely from a comfort standpoint, this is most comfortable, you know, what he's most familiar with. And sometimes as the score gets tighter and the pressure builds, trying something that you're not as well practiced on will call for a service error. So back to deuce, the second deuce this game. F- Flash in the crowd, not sure. Saw Ma Long point for a moment. Back edge, Huang Zhendong's asking for it. He got a full chole. Let's see. He didn't seem to follow up with the question. The conversation was ended with that point, I guess. Interesting, interesting. I think he would have pursued it more if he felt confident that it hit the back edge. It was just a question of maybe did it hit? Did it hit?
Yeah.
We all know that one. Just want to check with someone who was a little bit closer. Championship point again. Oh man!
And with a backhand flick and kill off with a counter forehand.
The squatting forehand, racket over the head. Who does this? Huang Zhendong once again with his back against the ropes.
Incredible physicality.
As the pressure gets higher and greater, so does the shot. Talk about performance. This is what makes a champion. How do you respond to pressure? The best shots we've seen this match have been against championship point.
Both players cool as ice out there as well.
Not using the towel. Backhand as deep as they come, and Ma Long with the head down for a moment, trying to cool himself. Literally out there blowing on the fingertips. I don't normally say just turn it on for the last few points of the match. For table tennis, it's not a highlights game to really understand the rhythm of the sport and what it means to work the game. You have to watch every point. But the last 6 points that we've seen, 7 points, have just been out of this world. Once again, he gets a slightly slower shot from Ma Long, crossing the body and burns him.
Wow, incredible stuff. Fan Zhendong's right back in the mix here.
Now this is, again, we bring it back to if there is any weakness in Ma Long's game, which of course is all relative, it's when he gets a little bit less confident. Even here in this tournament, the only player really to cause any damage was Li Ping. Got him nervous, got him questioning his game. Smart forehand, plays it back down the line. Again, the agility to turn and just twist the waist, wrap around the ball. I would have guessed he was going down the backhand corner, going cross court with that from the moment he turned.
But from a Fan Zhendong perspective, that's fine because he's been proactive on the flick receive. I think the more he can get this backhand into this match again, the more he'll take control. Just missed that one.
Yeah, the arc on it, the trajectory, just a little bit higher and spinnier than usual. The soft, spinny one, if he can keep it low to the net, he'll follow up with a ripping cannon backhand. It's setting it up, the opener. Two off the top of the net. No. Broken ball, they're gonna replay. No, Ma Long says nope. This is where I wish I had better Mandarin. This is interesting. Huang Zhendong has asked for two, just to check. Still a discussion. Huang Zhendong is saying, look at the replay. They're watching the big screen, I don't know.
No, and he's now saying sorry, I think. I think that was kind of pretty clear that it hit the top of the net and went off. It did change direction, but was more to the net, I think, than the edge of the table.
Oh, I didn't know that's what the conversation was. I could have misunderstood it. They didn't get a new ball at all, right?
I think that's what it was. I think it maybe whether it was clipping the side of the table or not. But
I think
the direction was changed from the net rather than the edge.
Got it.
3-2, 3-2.
This reminds me of the Yu Zhiyang moment at the Japan Open versus Jun Mizutani. Only to the top Chinese players who can hit it so hard will there ever be that much question about what it hit. Wow, Ma Long definitely looking like a different player. Stress-wise, you can see it on his face. He's wearing it. Fan Zhendong if he wins this game from a momentum standpoint. Remember we talked about how sweet it was when he was down 0-3? I mean, that was just a conversation topic. Right now it's a reality. This could go to a deciding seventh from down 0-3 against world number one.
It is a possibility.
Softer spinny, but still that corking sound of the clean backhand loop. Yeah, he looked so confident and patient. Wasn't trying to finish the point. Just set it up, and Ma Long, we've seen Ma Long take more aggressive shots. This is the hesitant Ma Long. This is the Ma Long that is stressing a little bit in the decision making.
This is the Ma Long that's actually human.
Right, I think that's something that we all have to remind ourselves of. Despite a great shot here right off the back edge of the table, Fan Zhendong comfortably brings it back. A little bit of help off the top of the net.
All of a sudden, Fan Zhendong gets himself into position where the 3-3 back from the brink of 3-0 truly is a possibility. Once again, Adam, I'm going to sound like a broken record, but it's the backhand from Fan Zhendong. As soon as he gets the backhand in, he's in control. Ma Long has stopped serving to the short forehand of Fan Zhendong, keeping him tight and then zipping over the table. Instead, Fan Zhendong now is getting in with that backhand of his, dictating.
Finally, a point that goes the way of Ma Long. For me, not only is he just getting in, he's been getting under the skin of Ma Long. I mean, this is part of the reason the mistake, well, the word mistake is such a tough word to use. I mean, these players are both absolute masters of the game, but he's been forcing mistakes out of Ma Long or earning points. It's because he's getting him so nervous and proving himself out here. Ma Long regathering, regaining confidence, backhand over the middle to the middle. Again, the shortest shot on the table from the middle is just that.
Interesting just watching Ma Long's response. There's no celebration, there's no speed to the barrier. He just walks coolly back, comes back to the table, almost like going through a period of contemplation.
Oh, beautiful backhand from the center of the table. It looked like he could have pushed it one more time. The surprise, just even the fact that he was flipping right here. But then where it goes, all Ma Long could do is swing with the offhand. So fast.
Beautiful. Look at the racket. So high, flick through at speed.
Fan Zhendong pulling the Duhoi Kim out there. Tough to say who did it first, but. 2-point lead for Fan Zhendong on the receive. Oh my goodness, Ma Long again, a quick turn. 1-point game. It's easy to get ahead of yourself sitting here and think about game seven when Fan Zhendong starts turning it on, but that's still a ways away, if it will come. Look at this angle. How does he do that? The ball's middle of the table and he plays it off the side with the Chiquita. Half long when he takes it. Little in near the net, but he's at the baseline of the table when he starts that stroke.
And to do that, not in the training hall, but at this point in the grand final final.
Right.
He's doing the right thing, Fan Zhendong, at every opportunity, going for that backhand. He's got to. It's the thing that's defining how he progresses here. And Ma Long knows it too. So even if he misses it, it still says to Ma Long, I'm going to go for this when I get the chance. So it'll keep Ma Long on his toes.
And that is sort of the tactics of sports psychology, right? Thinking not just about the shot and the opponent, but what the opponent might be thinking is also an important thing to consider.
Change of receive went long that time. Ma Long gets himself back to 8-all. Are we going to a seventh?
Get me to the next point. And Ma Long stepping back into the lead, changing up the length of serve, playing it deep into the middle. Again, that banana flick has been so impressive over the table that if Fan Zhendong's anticipating and trying to come in, Ma Long can break the plan.
Interestingly, he seems to have given up on the high toss forehand serve, Ma Long. He's reverting back to the shorter toss.
Ma Long, wow, Ma Long gives up on nothing. Wrong side of the table. Look at this, off the top of the net, it does not come down after all this struggle. Game six. Man, if that comes down, it's not gonna be an easy ball to get either, right near the net. Maybe the topspin would have brought it back to a hittable point. Still job not done yet. If we're gonna see any celebration, we talked about the humility in winning the point of Ma Long. It will be if he wins this point here.
Two more championship points, already had four. Here he has two more.
See what you're doing. Six championship points, this is his sixth.
Oh!
This is where Fan Zhendong shines. Give me a championship point for the opponent. That's all I need down the line. Ma Long turning, starts to turn early and cannot recover.
That is world class.
One championship point saved again.
So five saved now, right?
That's right. Does he have one more? He's got the serve to start the point.
The suspense.
No, it's off the top of the net and out.